Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Dear viewers, welcome to all of you in basic piping and welding course class. So today I am going to be start lecture 19. In this lecture I will try to share with you some basic information about the welding imperfection. So this is the first lecture related to the welding imperfection. So I will try to share with you some basic information in this lecture. So you are watching from YouTube channel Mohammad and Facebook page Watch and Learn. And if you still didn't subscribe my YouTube channel, please don't forget to subscribe and click the bell icon to get the all update lecture. Okay, let's see what we have in today lecture. So welding imperfection, what is the welding imperfection definition? So imperfection is the any deviation from the ideal weld. So this is called the imperfection. Then defect is an unacceptable imperfection. So imperfection, if it is unacceptable, then this is called the defect. And discontinuities is the if imperfection is the within acceptable range, this is actually called the discontinuities. So discontinuities can be ignored since they are always well within the acceptable production error margin. So if discontinuity is the within acceptable range, so you can we can accept the this type of weld. So you need to remember defect must be repaired. If the defect is irreparable, the product should get a red reject tag and head to the junk bin. So if really defect cannot be repaired, so this one we need to throw the material. So the standard classifies the geometry imperfection in fusion welding, dividing them into six groups. So cracks is the number one, then number two is the cavities, then solid inclination, lack of fusion and penetration, and imperfect shape and dimension, and miscellaneous imperfection. So these six categories actually that define the imperfection. So it is important that an imperfection is correctly identified so the cause can be established and action taken to prevent further occurrence. So first of things, we need to identify the what is the imperfection, and second things, we need to identify why this imperfection is caused, and third, we need to set the system how we can prevent this type of imperfection for further occurrence. So these three things we need to remember. So cracks, actually imperfection produced by a local rupture in the solid state, which may arise from the effect of cooling or stress. Cracks are more significant than other type of imperfection as their geometry produce a very large stress concentration at the crack tip, making them more likely to cause fracture. So crack is the most important imperfection, so we need to look on it. So this is the crack, you can see the picture, this is called the crack. So this is the hatch hydrogen crack initiated at the weld 2. So this is initiated from the weld 2. Most cracks are initiated from stress concentration. So due to the stress concentration, actually crack is initiated. So types of crack, how many types of crack is there? So longitudinal cracks, transverse cracks, radiating. Cracks radiating from a common point actually, then the crater, then branching. So branching or group of connected cracks originating from a common crack. So this crack can be situated in the weld metal, hatch, heat affected zone, and parent metal. Exception, crater cracks are found only in the weld metal. So you can say the crater crack only found the weld metal. So depending on their nature, this crack can be hot crack. So hot crack we call the solidification or liquefaction crack. The another is the precipitation induced, so reheat crack present in creep resistant steels. The another is the cool crack. So cool cracks we know as a hydrogen induced crack. So another defect is the laminar tearing. So we can see the next slide. So hot crack, what is the hot crack? So depending on their location and mode of occurrence, hot crack can be solidification crack and liquefaction crack. So what is the solidification crack? So solidification crack actually occur in the weld metal, usually along the central line of the weld, as a result of the solidifying process. So this is the weld metal. Actually, this solidification crack is occurred in the center of the weld due to the solidification process. So solidification cracks, generally solidification cracks can occur when weld metal has a high carbon or impurity content. So sulfur content is there is the high. So this solidification crack can be happened. Second thing, the depth to weight ratio of the solidifying weld bead is large, deep and narrow. Then disruption of the heat flow condition occurrence, stop start condition. So for this the reason solidification crack can be happened. So you can see the picture. This is the solidification crack in center of the weld. Then shrinkage is strained. So this when the after welding, when this is the cooling down, then this is strain is working here. So can be the solidification crack, and then there is a sulfur and heat decreased flame. If the impurity is many, then it can be the solidification crack happen. The solidification crack. So solidification crack, the depth to weight ratio of the solidifying weld bead is large, deep and narrow. So you can see from picture, this is the weld, this is the depth. So this is the one example depth to weight ratio. So solidification crack, the this crack can be wide and open to the surface like shrinkage voids or subsurface and possible narrow. The second thing is the solidification cracking is most likely to occur in composition and result in a wide freezing temperature range. In steels, this is commonly created by a higher than normal content of carbon and impurity element such as sulfur and phosphorus. So third thing is these elements segregate during solidification so that intergranular liquid field remain after the bulk of this weld has solidified. The thermal shrinkage of the cooling weld bead can cause this to rupture and form a crack. So another hot crack is the liquidation crack. So liquidation crack can occur during fabrication by welding in either the heat affected zone in the parent material or the previously deposited weld metal during a subsequent run. It result from localized melting and at grain or other boundaries combined with the thermal strain associated with welding. So liquidation crack can be the heat affected zone area. So this is the can be the heat affected zone area. So you can see the here is the crack. Second thing is it can be the weld metal deposited. Maybe this weld is do the first run welding, then we are doing the another subsequent run. So from a weld metal also can be this liquidation crack. So you can see from the weld metal liquidation crack. So here is the welding liquidation crack. So from here you can see the solidification crack also. So this is the central line of the weld. So I hope you understand this topic. So that's all. This is in today lecture. So if you have any question about in these topics, you can ask me in comment section, and your valuable feedbacks and comment will be help me to do the more good lectures. So thanks to all for watching the watching lecture. So see you soon in my next lecture. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.